After England's Rugby World Cup heroics, is this the next sweet chariot to bring us sporting glory? The Chinese Grand Prix at Shanghai could bring us Formula One history and could complete one of the great stories in sport, the ultimate realization of a boyhood dream.
I've got Ron Dennis's phone number. I can phone him in 9 years and I'll get to phone him. And he might give me a free drive in McLaren.
What might he achieve in the future?
I just want to go out and enjoy myself. Yeah. That's the whole reason I do this one. That's the whole reason I went go-karting, because I enjoyed it. It wasn't because there was a possibility of getting to Formula One. It was just because I enjoy driving a car, and that's what I'm going to do tomorrow. So, fingers crossed, with that mentality and if everything goes right, we will win.
And that's the kind of attitude and self-belief that has helped Britain's Lewis Hamilton produce the most amazing debut season that Formula One has ever seen. Now from pole position at this Chinese Grand Prix in Shanghai, can he crown it all by becoming the youngest world champion in the history of the sport? We're in for an amazing couple of hours. We were due to be in for a very wet couple of hours, and apart from a few heavy showers, we're enduring one right at the moment. There's no sign yet of the consistent heavy rain that was supposed to accompany a local tornado. We are getting showers, it's hot and it's humid, but we know from the evidence of Japan that Britain's Lewis Hamilton can cope with just about anything. So what exactly does he have to do to claim the world title here in China? Well, he heads the grid and he heads the world championship table by 12 points, two races left. He's qualified ahead of Alonso and Raikkonen. If he finishes ahead of them, he takes the title. If Raikkonen wins and Hamilton finishes ahead of Alonso, no worse than sixth, he's the champion. It's looking very good indeed, but of course, it could still go to a last race decider in Brazil. Mark Blundell, how excited are you about the possibilities of the next couple of hours?
Very excited. I think everybody's excited. Great anticipation here in the paddock. But the big question mark is the weather. As we're standing here now, the rain's coming down a bit heavier. I've just spoken to Phil Brew, Lewis Hamilton's engineer, and already they're thinking about tyre choice and whether they need to make a choice and decision with this rain coming even heavier.
It's nothing like the rain we had in Japan last weekend yet, although that possibly is going to be forecast for a little bit later. There's going to be a lot of confusion about tyres in the pit lane.
Yeah, there will be. It's not extreme rain. I think it's more of a case of whether they run an intermediate tyre or whether they normally run their proper dry tyre. So that's the big decision for them. As we stand at the moment, I don't think anybody wants to make a decision. They don't have to. They've got a little bit of time left.
Well, everyone is getting fired up in every respect for what's to come. Lewis Hamilton's race preparations and indeed his race prospects were almost compromised by the threat of a points penalty or a grid penalty that only went away after he had to endure a very tough day indeed on Friday. It was the climax of a day of confusion and uncertainty for Lewis. His apparently erratic driving behind the safety car at Fuji left him facing the stewards on Friday evening. The verdict that the conditions were so challenging that no one should be penalised was a relief. But when you saw the media's interest in the verdict as well, you realised the pressure he'd been put under ahead of such a vital weekend. It made what he did less than 24 hours later all the more impressive. James Allen reports on qualifying.
As a thrilling world championship reaches its climax, yesterday it got a qualifying session that was truly worthy of it. There were some outstanding performances throughout the field. Jenson Button, in an awkward-looking Honda, managed to get a great lap time. He's 10th on the grid. Ralf Schumacher, on his penultimate outing for Toyota, is 6th. And veteran David Coulthard in the Red Bull had his best showing of the season. He wound up 5th on the grid, ahead of teammate Webber. In the first two parts of qualifying, the order at the front was Raikkonen, Massa, Alonso, Hamilton. But that was all to change in the important pole position shootout. Alonso was furious with his lap. He wound up fourth. Massa made a small mistake en route to third. Raikkonen was blindingly fast, but he found another car in front of him on the grid. A dramatic and unexpected pole for Hamilton then. He leads the field into the uncertain weather conditions this afternoon.
P1 Lewis, job done.
So it's the sixth pole position of this 2007 season for Lewis Hamilton, his 11th time on the front row. But he's got Kimi Raikkonen right alongside him. Through to row two, Felipe Massa and Fernando Alonso, the ninth time this season that Hamilton's outqualified him. Coulthard and Ralf Schumacher make up row three. Row four, Mark Webber in the second of the Red Bulls alongside BMW's Nick Heidfeld. Robert Kubica was outqualified by his teammate by 17 one-thousandths of a second. He's got Jenson Button alongside him on row five. Row six, Tony Oliuzzi and Jarno Trulli, a bit out of sorts here in China. Renault were terrible in qualifying. Heikki Kovalainen 13th alongside Anthony Davidson. Then it's Nico Rosberg again, the Williams team misfiring here, and Rubens Barrichello making up row eight. Row 9, Sebastian Vettel moved back five places for blocking another car. He's got Giancarlo Fisichella with him. It's Wurz and Sato making up row 10. And right at the back, the Spikers are not really on form here. Sutil and Yamamoto.
Well, it was calm perfection from Lewis Hamilton, which contrasted so much with the frustration of Fernando Alonso yesterday afternoon. He really let loose that frustration when he got back to the motorhome here, didn't he?
Definitely. There were some big stories floating around where he'd thrown a helmet to the ground, he'd broken doors off of hinges. A very frustrated driver, and I think he's also been very vocal to the Spanish media, and definitely some problems there. Whether he's around next year, that's another big question, but not one that he needs to answer now.
What does that tell you about his potential attitude to the race to come, his potential aggressive attitude?
I think he's going to be sitting on the grid with a level of aggression. Whether that comes out on the start, we'll have to wait and see. But at the same time, I think yesterday in qualifying, it just signaled to him, this is going to be very, very tough now to pull this championship off. And, you know, and again, he sits alongside a rookie, somebody who's walked into Formula One, and is beaten in fair and square in the same equipment. Very tough to swallow.
But Lewis arriving this morning absolutely calm, given the kind of destiny, the day of destiny that lies ahead of him. How do you feel that he coped with all the events that were surrounding him on Friday? How did he actually manage to come through that and perform like he did on Saturday?
You know, we've talked about this a lot. It's just a strength that Lewis Hamilton has. He has got this mind management down to a T, and he can get information, he can get pressure, and he just parks it somewhere in his brain, and he doesn't worry about it. He just leaves enough capacity to focus on the job in hand and drive a race car as quickly as possible, and at the moment drive it quicker than most,
and the time also to sign as many autographs as he physically can, even on a day like this. Well, these were the opinions of some of the leading drivers at the end of qualifying yesterday.
Absolutely thrilled to get the pole position, because going into qualifying I didn't particularly have the pace of Fernando, and you know, I knew that if I just worked at it, don't put too much effort into it, just, you know, just a little bit, I might be able to do it, and I did, so I'm very, very happy.
I'm a little bit pessimistic after the result of today, and after also, you know, what happened all weekend as well. You know, I really think that the destiny is not my year this time.
Probably there is different fuel loads in the cars. I'm very happy with the car, it's been good. I think so. We have a good car in the race, whatever conditions we will get, and it has been a good weekend.
But a little bit surprised, because honestly, just driving the same way as I did in the previous few qualifyings, but for some reason, people are behind me, so I'm not complaining. I'm obviously happy with that. It should give us a good start.
It's great to be in the top 10, and tomorrow, hopefully, we'll get another chance to do a good job.
And we're looking for strong performances today from Jenson Button, and especially from David Coulthard, who produced his best qualifying performance in some 53 races yesterday. Only one world champion in this Chinese Grand Prix field. That, of course, is Fernando Alonso, the champion for the last 2 years. But is he about to relinquish that title to Lewis Hamilton? Is Lewis Hamilton about to join the list of eight British drivers who have claimed the Formula One World Championship title? talking to Lewis Hamilton in some detail a little later in our build-up, and I have to say he finds it very hard to disguise his confidence and his belief that he is going to become the ninth British driver to win the Formula One World Championship. That used to be the ambition of Jenson Button, and I suppose in many ways it still is, but after a season that Jenson has spent bringing the absolute maximum from his underperforming Honda, he's rather sort of revised his perspective as to what goes to make a really good motor car. Or at least, that's what Louise has been finding out.
Every time. Awesome. That is excellent, isn't it?
How do you like my wheels?
That is beautiful.
It's cool, isn't it?
How are you doing?
I'm good, how are you?
Good.
It's nice,
wow,
isn't it?
It's in good condition.
How does it compare?
This is a slightly newer model than mine.
I've been learning all about them, actually. You've got the split screen, haven't you? Which is like the really, that's
six,
the real classic, isn't it?
5060 is the first one they made. But no, they're amazing bits of kit. They're so simple. I've just blown up the engine of mine, by the way.
Have you?
Yeah. Just blown it up. It's a place I go. When you drive one of these, the amount of smiles you get from people and thumbs up, and it just makes people happy. Mine's got like bench seats, so I can take the crew out. It's proper hippie style.
So has this brought back happy memories of your camper?
It has. You know, I had the best week's holiday in France in my camper with my girlfriend. I think a lot of it is down to her being a little bit of a hippie. But no, it's the first time I've been camping, so putting up a tent. It was hilarious. An hour and a half to get this tent up that was the size, I don't know, it was the size of one of our motorhomes. It was massive, this thing.
Obviously, Honda introduced the concept of the Earth car at the beginning of this season. Do you think it's been a success?
Well, it's not very fast. So it's environmentally friendly, yes. And I think the concept's worked, yeah. You know, it needed to be done. The Formula One world needed to know that there are issues out there, and also that we're trying to make a difference.
The media are all horribly fickle. We've switched our attention to Lewis Hamilton this year. Has it been a blessing for you when you're having a horrible season that the attention isn't on you?
Lewis deserves all the credit he's had, you know, all the positive press that he's had this year. He's done a great job. It's been quite demoralising at times, especially at the start of the year when I first jumped in the car. Said, this car isn't going to work, you know. And every time I jumped in it, it was just made me so angry, you know, because you just weren't in control of it. For a driver, that is the worst feeling in the world, you know, an inconsistent car.
Has it been your worst season ever in motor racing?
Yeah, it has, yeah, I'd say. I had a pretty bad year in karting when I was about 14. That's because I realised that girls existed more than anything else.
How confident are you that Honda are going to make a recovery next season?
If you look at this year's car, you'd think, wow, how did we get it so wrong? And I think it's because we went one direction with it and it was the wrong one.
There's been a lot of talk in the paddock recently about there perhaps being a vacant seat at McLaren. Would you consider moving?
Well, it's nice that people are talking about me like that. You know, I think it's important that people are always talking about you for different seats in Formula One. But I'm with Honda next year, yes.
Is this the first interview you've done in a field?
For a long, long time, and it's freezing as well, isn't it?
Well, you can warm up now, because we're going to the Silverstone experience, and you're going to experience Silverstone in a way you've never experienced it before, I'm quite sure. You can do that and I can't. Go on, my son. Are you all five, Bernie?
Still a bit.
Well, it's not really a day for mountain biking here in Shanghai, but Pat, I wanted to ask you about the conditions. What are you looking at the moment in terms of going to the grid? What tyres, what strategy?
Well, we're always trying to look at the tyres that will give us most grip, and, you know, we'll always err on the side of the drier tyre. Very, very changeable conditions, very hard conditions to predict. Our forecasts have been moving all over the place. Right at the moment, we go out on dries, but it can change any minute.
Okay, looking at the front of the field, the championship, Lewis, a really good chance to wrap it up today. You think Fernando can hold on?
Yeah, well, I think a lot's going to come down to the weather. Those first four cars are on much shorter strategies than everyone else. If it rains partway through the race, it can just put everything on its head.
Okay, very interesting. We'll look out for it. Thanks very much, Pat.
Cheers.
And certainly not a great day for Jenson Button's camper van either. It's warm, it's windy down the pit straight. Showers moving in about every 5 minutes or so. A very difficult day to make absolutely the right tyre choice. Very different day to the Japanese Grand Prix last Sunday when it was consistently wet, very wet indeed. One thing that we did learn from Japan last Sunday, when you put wet conditions together with the courage of these Formula One drivers, the resulting race can be quite spectacular.
So this,
you can see a thing. I really wish I could show everyone exactly how it felt. I mean, I think, I'm sure you saw the onboard camera. Just imagine that in the helmet.
And we are racing at Fuji Speedway. Heidfeld has had a problem.
Jensen was up the inside and Heidfeld turned in. Wurz lost it under braking then.
I didn't see anything out there. I had to just look to the side where the grass is to know where I am roughly.
And this is why Alonso went off the road, touched the white line, and went straight onto the AstroTurf.
Oh no, there is Lewis Hamilton.
Kvyat's gone for the inside normal racing line and just understeered clean into Lewis, who would not have seen that one coming at all.
One of the two main championship contenders, Fernando Alonso, has hit the wall.
That's critical for the world championship.
I had aquaplaning and, you know, the car was into the wall.
Vettel has run into the back of Mark Webber while they've been warming tyres and brakes.
Kids with not enough experience doing a good job and they f***ed all up.
I just saw Lewis braking or slowing down. I was wondering, and in the same moment I was already in Mark's rear end, so of course I'm very sorry.
Look, Raikkonen's gone right round the outside of five this time though. It's where he was quicker last time.
The problem when you're behind everybody, you cannot see anything 50 meters in front of you, it's nothing, and you just hope that there's nothing stopped or slowing down.
Kubica and Massa are battling here.
I think we both play very aggressive, but quite nice.
Fortunately, I saw Massa on the last lap, so I went wide, and we touched. If you would give me half meter, I would manage to go, but unfortunately he didn't saw me probably.
It has been one of the most difficult and treacherous Grand Prix in the history of Formula One racing. Lewis Hamilton wins the Japanese Grand Prix.
If he wins the World Championship this year, he fully deserves it, just on the back of this afternoon.
It was astonishing stuff. He has nothing left to prove of his ability as a wet weather driver. What does he still need to learn about following a safety car in the wet? What were the lessons of last week for Lewis?
I think there was just a little bit of criticism from a lot of the guys just because the speed behind a pace car was not quite consistent. But, you know, that's just a bit of inexperience. And to be honest with you, he's got every right to be out there trying to make up tyre temperatures and brake temperatures. But, you know, you can see him now. The guy's chilled out, Steve. He's one of these guys, he makes sure that everybody in the garage is fully behind him. He's got a good relationship there with Phil Prue, his engineer, and, you know, he's going to make sure it counts.
Well, his team really appreciated what he did in the wet at Fuji last weekend, and they're all saying to him, go out and do it again. Go out and become world champion. Well, Lewis, master of the wet last week, and in perfect conditions yesterday, he reigned supreme once again. Martin Brundle looks at his pole position lap of yesterday afternoon.
It's the fourth Chinese Grand Prix at the Shanghai International Circuit. 3 1/3 miles, around 96 seconds for a hot lap. Let's take a look at a textbook.
Absolute pole position perfection from Lewis Hamilton yesterday afternoon. Out in the pit lane here, we're just enduring another of those brisk showers that are sweeping across this Shanghai circuit. The umbrellas are up and down in the crowd that's gathering in the main stand. And the crowd that's there, I wonder what sort of view they'll get of any kind of celebrations on the podium at the end of events here at the Chinese Grand Prix. Surely there can be no better feeling than to stand on the top step of that podium and celebrate a victory that confirms you as world champion. Ted Kravitz looks at the whole range of emotions we see on a Formula One podium.
It's an essential part of Formula One theatre, the climax of the race and of the entire weekend. But it's also home to silly jumps, random gestures, and bouts of high emotion. It's cherished by every driver. It's the drug they crave. It's the podium.
For a driver, it's the maximum, no doubt.
It's just great. You feel the king of the world. You are on the top of the podium.
It's fantastic. I mean, you know, it's a really good feeling. Unfortunately, it's always far too short.
It's the best what a driver could aim for.
There's always some kissing going on.
You walk to the podium, and it's a moment that you are completely alone. You are taking the helmet off, the gloves, etc. And it's a moment to think about all the weekend, all, you know, the people that you, it's important for you, your family, etc. It's a moment that you are alone, probably the only one after the race.
If you are in a team which regularly is on the podium, kind of get used to it. You're always disappointed if you're not on the top place on the podium. But if you are like me in my career and the teams which sometimes can have just a sniff to the podium and you really achieve that goal, it's fantastic.
It feels like a huge difference, but in fact it is only 1 point, so it shouldn't matter too much. But just being up there, enjoying the ceremony, getting the trophy, seeing your team, and just all the atmosphere just gives you something.
The time when they were booing for Michael in Austria, and you have the whole world for you in that, it feels odd. So I felt sad for him.
If you've won the race, you want everyone to soak you through, and you normally just spray it over your dad or the team members, and then end up with it on your head, which is the normal one.
Well, normally I catch Lewis's bottle because he'll usher me over to the podium and I'll catch it basically.
What's your record this season?
10 out of 10 so far.
Well, I prefer to call it a controlled landing. I've dropped one this year and it didn't break, so that's all right.
It should make a little slide down so you have less risk of dropping and smashing the bottle.
I was on the podium, obviously extremely happy, and at the end you're exhausted and you're just relieved if you do get the win. That's a great feeling when you come out of a race and you've won, you know you've done it to perfection. It's the greatest feeling ever.
Well, I have with me now a man who stood on the top step of that podium 27 times and took 3 world championships. The big question everybody back at home wants to know today is, can Lewis win the title here?
I think he can. I would love to think he will. We are standing here right now and there's just been a very quick, heavy shower of rain. I think the changing conditions are going to make it difficult, but I'd love him to win the world championship in his rookie year.
It'll be a big thing for Britain, wouldn't it?
Unbelievable for Britain. I think he is going to be the biggest sports star in Britain, and I think for probably many years.
Thanks very much, Jackie.
Pleasure.
Yes, it was a very heavy rain shower indeed that has swept across the pit lane. It even induced a few screams from up there in the grandstand. Does it affect the thinking once again? Are we getting close to formerly wet conditions here?
I still think there's enough humidity and enough time for the track to dry out quickly, Steve, so it won't be a big problem. But if it stays a little bit more consistent and we get that heaviness in the showers, then all of a sudden they're going to have to think about an intermediate tyre.
How much will this sort of intervene in Lewis's mindset ahead of this race? Does it complicate things for him?
You know, after the season he's had and everything that's gone on, I don't think this is going to be a big problem for him. And he's got a lot of bright guys around him making decisions for him in some ways, and I think they'll be analysing this as we speak.
Well, there are still 2 races left in this Formula One World Championship. It might still come down to a last round decider in Brazil. It might be about to reach its climax here in China. But we'll look back on it as producing scandal, controversy, history, record-breaking performances, and some stunning action. This has been one of the best Formula One seasons ever.
Sometimes you gotta
point we must make from Lewis's point of view. It won't just be a world championship. During the course of this past season, he's had to endure every examination, mental examination, physical examination, his driving skills, he's come through everything.
He's had everything thrown at him, and as I say, I don't think an experienced driver could take some of the pressures that he's had to go through in his first year. Very difficult indeed. But as I say again, he's walked through all of it, come out the other end and been a winner. And I think this is going to be the confirmation that he's going to actually come through and pull the championship off.
And you don't doubt that he's got the mental strength to come through whatever the next couple of hours hold in store for him.
Yeah, you've seen as many races of his this year as me, and every time we look at him and he gets stronger and stronger, the more pressure you throw at Lewis Hamilton, the more he reacts and he goes up another step. I don't know where the top of the ladder is for him, but you know, I don't think we've seen it yet.
Fernando Alonso, who has just gone out from the garage slot alongside. If you were Lewis, what would you expect from Fernando this afternoon?
I think Fernando may be a beaten man at this point. I really do. I think psychologically, I think he's had a little bit of a beating over the course of the weekend. He didn't do what he wanted to do, and that was get on pole position, and he didn't beat his teammate, and he's a row behind him. He's got a lot of work to do, Steve. Lewis just goes out, does his normal job. He's got everything on his side.
But there's a sense of destiny. I'm sure you feel that as well within that garage, not just from Lewis's point of view, but from the whole McLaren point of view. They're sort of feeling that they're in touch with the future of Formula One here.
Yeah, definitely. And I think, you know, McLaren have had a very difficult season. They've had the Constructors' title taken away from them. All they've got left is to pull off this World Championship for the driver. And I think Lewis Hamilton, he's been there since a child, and all of a sudden it looks like they're going to make some very historic situation with this win. He scored over 100 World Championship points in his first season. There's only about 6 or 7 drivers in the world ever done that. It's remarkable.
Yes, no other driver in the history of this great sport has reached 100 points as swiftly as Lewis Hamilton. I mean, that shows his potential and it shows his pedigree that you can rank him alongside the likes of Senna and Prost and Fangio and everyone else. And he's going to be up there with the greats, isn't he?
He definitely is. He's already there in many ways because what he has done in his first year. But, you know, we're at the beginning of the curve for Lewis Hamilton. We've got a lot more to come from him. And I think next season, if he does pull off this championship, will be even better.
Well, before all that, there is a race, and it's a complicated race to prepare for. They're in no rush to leave the garage there, and tyres must be the principal topic of conversation.
Yeah, that will be the decision now that everybody has to take. What tyre? If it was me at this moment, it would still be that you'd be on the dry tyre, Steve. I don't see anything else other than that. Maybe they'll go out and take this acceleration lap, and Lewis will be on the radio telling the team what he feels.
Away he goes. Whatever lies in store, and quite possibly it is a world championship title in his first season in Formula One. A couple of hours of real sporting tension coming up for you. And that's if you've calmed down after England's magnificent Rugby World Cup performance against Australia. You'll be reassured, by the way, to know that England's heroes are already turning their attention to the next big sporting challenge. Though it's not France in the semi-finals, they can wait. They, like everyone else, have got their attention firmly on events and expectations here in Shanghai.
It's a good luck message to Lewis Hamilton. The whole country's behind you, mate. We're really wishing you very well for the last two Grand Prix, and we just want to see you lift that world title.
Just a good luck message for you, Lewis, coming into obviously what's a big time for you. All the England team wishing you the best, wishing it all goes well for you. Congratulations on all you've achieved, all your hard work and all you deserve.
Big good luck to you. We know it's a massive race for you, but from myself and all the boys here at England, wish you all the best.
The Shanghai circuit in damp, showery conditions, not yet the kind of conditions that provided such a test of courage and concentration in Japan last weekend, but it may well become a great deal worse. Lewis Hamilton proved more than equal to the examination then. I talked to him yesterday afternoon and he was looking back on a tough last couple of days.
Well, you know, I turned up on Thursday and I heard that I was going to be, I was under investigation for dangerous driving or my driving under the safety car, which was a complete surprise to me. I wasn't happy about it. It was, you know, people said just put out your mind and do your job on the track, and it was really difficult to do that and focus 100% when you've got something that could be so crucial to all the work that you've done and all the people around you that have done. So it's extra pressure, which is not needed. Obviously the right decision came out of it, so an emotional weekend so far, but it's getting better. So
you've talked before about your frustration with the politics of the sport, and obviously in the last 24 hours a lot of that has got resurrected back home, and the feeling back home maybe is that you've got a sort of disenchantment potentially with Formula One, and that your future with the sport might be relatively short-lived. Put our minds at rest in that respect.
Well, it's really difficult, that one, because for so many years I've dreamt of being a Formula One driver, and it is what I love doing. I honestly couldn't say that I'd want to be doing anything else. But taking all the politics and everything, to put that out of your mind and just get on with your job, which is what I want to do, is really, really tricky, because they keep putting it in your face. You know? Fingers crossed, you know, I'm doing the best job I can to stay completely out of trouble. So that means, you know, just trying not to put the foot wrong. And as long as you're squeaky clean, they can't do anything to you. So that's the most important thing. I've got to try and do that. And as long as I'm enjoying it, which, you know, when I got in the car today, without that stress on my mind, I enjoyed it 100%.
Sometimes the sport does have to take a break from politics, and if you were able to clinch it tomorrow, what would it mean to you? We know all the history of the Constructors' Championship and the penalty that's been imposed there, but what would it mean to you to have Ron Dennis on the rostrum with you to celebrate a World Championship title?
It would mean the world to me. When everyone told Ron that he was crazy picking me up all those years ago, I think he'll be extremely proud, I hope, but also my family as well. But it'll be just great to see my dad down there smiling and know that he's happy, and to know that all my family back home are happy as well. It's there will definitely be no better feeling that I'm sure that I'll ever experience in my life. I just want to go out and enjoy myself. You know, that's the whole reason I do this sport. That's the whole reason I went go-karting, is because I enjoyed it. It wasn't because there was a possibility of getting to Formula One. It was just because I enjoy driving a car, and that's what I'm going to do tomorrow. So fingers crossed with that mentality, and if everything goes right, we will win.
Well, Pedro, we were just hearing from Lewis there. He seems so calm. What's the atmosphere like on this very important day for the team?
I think that both drivers are very calm under very difficult circumstances, because I think that it's not only what's at stake, but also in which conditions, because it's not easy for any driver to pick up the correct tire under these circumstances. And especially, I think that the key will be their communication between them and the race engineers. It's going to be very difficult to choose the correct tire, as I've said, and it's very important to, when you make your first pit stop, just that the conditions remain the same for everyone, because it would be quite unfair if you come in and it suddenly starts raining and you go with a dry tire. But it's a very difficult for a driver, but Luis is always so calm, it's unbelievable.
Felipe Massa arrives at the back of the grid. He'll be making his way up to row two to line up alongside Fernando Alonso. We'll be going down on that grid with Martin Brundle very shortly. Quick reminder, first of all, of the ITV F1 website, itv-f1.com, where you can get all the latest news and information on what's happening in the sport. And there's a lot to update you on as the season reaches its climax. And there's the ITV F1 competition as well.
This weekend, we're giving you and a friend a chance to be one of the first visitors to the Singapore Formula One Street Circuit. The inaugural night race on the 28th of September next year uses existing roads and some new sections currently under construction. You'll get to see the downtown circuit before anybody else in the Formula One world. You and a friend will be flown to Singapore at the beginning of next year. Stay three nights in a five-star hotel in the centre of this vibrant city. Have a private VIP tour of the proposed street circuit, plus a Singapore city tour. To be in with a chance of winning this fantastic prize, just answer this question. Which continent is Singapore in? Is it A, Asia, B, Africa, or C, Europe? The number to call is 0901-293-2020, or text F1 plus your answer, A, B or C, to 63337. Calls cost £1 per entry from a BT landline. Calls from other networks and mobiles may be higher. Text will cost £1 plus the standard network rate. Entrance must be 18 or over. Cable and satellite viewers can press the red button, and lines close at 6 p.m. on Thursday the 18th of October.
Good luck with that. The next Formula One season promises to be just as enthralling as this one. Jean Todt watches his two Ferrari drivers gather. Kimi Raikkonen, who will be on the front row alongside this man, Lewis Hamilton, who will be on pole position. Felipe Massa will be alongside Fernando Alonso. Mark, what were your thoughts about what Lewis had to say there, that if he is up on the podium in a couple of hours' time celebrating the World Championship, how appropriate it would be that Ron Dennis would be up there with him. And indeed, wouldn't it be nice if Anthony Hamilton was up there as well?
Yeah, I think it'd be fantastic to see Ron up there. I know the situation is because of the Constructors' Championship not being able to have those points that they can't have a representative on the podium, but it would be a great gesture just to see Ron up there and see, you know, pretty much his protege. This is a guy that he took on at nearly 10 years old. And there's Ron there. This will be something very special to him to see the situation of taking this young child and going all the way through to get to this end point. And it would be nice to see him there, but somehow it might not happen.
A lot of young kart drivers, 13, 14 years old, are showing some astonishing ability these days. What do you think it was that Ron Dennis spotted in Lewis at age 11 or 12?
Maybe a little bit of that cheekiness, going up to him and saying, can I have your phone number? And, you know, it seemed to work, didn't it? But it actually went one step more than that, because it's ended up that Ron's paying him several million dollars to drive his race car, which I'm sure he's actually quite happy about, because he's worth every penny. And he must be probably one of the most valuable drivers down the pit lane at this point.
And we saw Lewis Hamilton walking onto the grid with his father, Anthony Hamilton. He's played a great part, of course, in his passage through the sport. But it's been a great partnership with Ron, hasn't it?
Yeah, it has. They've done everything together over the last 10 years. They've made lots of decisions and they've gone through all the ranks of the lower formulas. And I think Anthony, you know, he's been a solid backbone for Lewis, you know, as a father and as a mentor as well in many ways. And you've seen Lewis grow up considerably over the last few years outside of the car as well as in it.
And Nico Rosberg there, who we saw will start back on row 8 with Sebastian Vettel, who's been relegated down the grid. He had a fairly influential father as well. Anthony Davidson, we're seeing, he'll start on row 7 with Heikki Kovalainen. But further up the grid, we've got Martin Brundle.
This is a hero and zero day. They've got to choose the right tyres at the right moment. We've looked at some weather radar. You've seen it earlier on. The rain is coming through every quarter of an hour or so. Major skirt around the circuit. I'm sitting in the safety car, the very car that led 19 laps of last weekend's Japanese Grand Prix. It's very hot in here, actually. They've got a TV screen in here to see the Formula One action. Now, this is a souped-up version even of the car that would scare you witless on the road. So why don't they have a full-on Formula One car that goes the same pace? And we don't get the aggravation we had last weekend. Well, this car has to be on the key. It has to be able to cope instantly with any track and weather conditions. And therefore, it's got to be really a super fast road car. Now, the little boy in me, the schoolboy in me, really wants to steal the key and run off with it and see how they cope with that. But Bernd Mailander is the driver. He's a professional driver. I'm pretty sure they won't be needing this car today. If they do, 1 minute before the action, they will turn on a green light that tells the rest of the field behind him that it's going to be a safety car start. If they're not anticipating using it, within 5 minutes of the start, we'll hear that burble away into the background. Now, this is going to be a bit of a challenge today, I suspect, to get hold of drivers. A lot of last-minute decisions going on. Here we are then. Let's just take a quick look at Lewis Hamilton's car. What a season he's had. He's just off the grid at the moment with a last-minute comfort break, a bit of a panic pee, I suspect, because the moment has arrived to see whether he can take this world championship today. He's gone through hell and literally high water to put himself on the front row of the grid, on pole position here, with a chance to take the world championship. He's had the big crash at the Nürburgring. He's had a gloves-off fight with his teammate. His team were virtually excluded at one point, and all sorts of other dramas. Somehow, in the middle of it all, he's kept his head to give himself this opportunity today. If he comes back on the grid, he's just walking along the other side of the pit wall, apparently. I don't know if he's on his way back or on his way. We've got rain predicted in 12 minutes. Aki Hintzer, one of the gurus at McLaren. Aki, what is the mental state of Lewis today?
It's perfect. This is one race. Actually, this is a very important race, but we have prepared just normal way. And I believe he's performing his 100% level mentally and physically as well.
Thank you, Aki. I'm going to go and try and find him, see if he'll actually talk to us. Lewis, quick word, ITV. Top man. Well, you've earned this chance, Lewis, to sit here on pole position today and with a chance to take the world championship. How are you going to play it?
I just approach it the same as I do every race, and you know, we're in the perfect spot to win the race, but it's going to be tricky. It's tricky conditions. You never know if it's going to rain more or less, and but you know, I'm going to do the best I can to win the race. So,
how is the track? Is it slicks or inters to start?
It's definitely inters. It's greasier and slipperier than, you know, twice as slippery as the last race. So,
thank you. Good luck, Lewis. Right, let's wander down the rest of the grid and see who else we can find. So, Lewis looking very, very relaxed there. And let's go and find David Coulthard. I'm going to miss the two Ferraris. They don't seem to want to talk to F1 ITV. I'm going to miss Fernando Alonso. It would be rather two-faced for me to talk to him today because, I have to say, I've said a few words about being thoroughly disappointed with the way that he has approached the season and approached his relationship with Lewis Hamilton. A quick word with David Coulthard. DC, massive performance then down here in P5. You must be well satisfied with that.
Yeah, absolutely. And it was a genuine qualifying session, so we had the pace. That's got to bode well for these conditions. Obviously, the wet run in Fuji, we showed quite competitive pace as well.
What gave you the extra confidence? Those dodgy shirts you had made in Hong Kong, or was it a new pieces on the car?
No, I think that we were able to switch our tyres on, and a lot of people were struggling to make them work. And just the nature of the track, I had good rear stability, so I could use my speed into the corners, and the lap time came.
Just tell us, David, who's going to make the decision finally when you go to dry tyres or back to intermediates? Rain's coming constantly this afternoon. Where does the buck stop on that?
To go to slicks, it's a driver, because you've got to have the confidence. Obviously, you rely a little bit on information from the team. To come back on to, you know, if we were on an extreme, for instance, onto an intermediate, you rely on the team to watch what other people are doing, or the driver can make the call that he's ready to go for that. So it really is a big team effort.
Thanks for your time. Let's wander down to Jenson Button, who's also had a very, very strong qualifying. Busy losing my radio here. We'll tuck that back in my pocket as we go. Don't know if we can have a word with Mark Webber, see if we can rib him a little bit about That's okay. They're expecting us down there.
I don't care. This goes.
Yeah. We just want a quick word with Jensen. What's the time? It's not 10:02. It's not 10 to the hour. No, it's not. You can't do that. We have to get off the grid at 10:02. You've got a job to do. I've got a job to do. We've got Keanu Reeves down there, Jenson Button. I've got millions of people want to know what he thinks. Okay, we can wander down there. Okay, Stevie, I think, I don't know where Jensen's car is. Where is his car? Right, it's a bit too far down there. So, back to you, Steve.
Good try, Martin. Just the kind of situation where he needed Keanu Reeves there, I think. But the mood fairly intense down there on that grid, and especially the mood surrounding Lewis Hamilton. Although he's been so relaxed during the course of the last 24 hours, the interview that he gave yesterday, he talked with great confidence about how he'd feel after the race, how he'd feel when the World Championship title was clinched. Makes you a bit nervous in some ways.
I don't think it's too bad a deal for him. He knows exactly what he's got to do. Martin spoke earlier with Aki, who's been his guy behind him in terms of getting his mind management right and looking after him in the off-season. And in between races, they go off to Finland and they do some therapeutic stuff there, and he knows how strong he is in the head department, and I think everything's going to be okay when it comes to this race. He'll just do the same as what he's done for every other Grand Prix this season.
And he's generating so much support around the followers of Formula One. There aren't many of those who think this is going to be in any way a tainted World Championship title.
Not at all. And I think because of the refreshing outlook he has on the track, he doesn't think twice. He thinks once and he makes a move, and he's taken people by surprise. None more so than Raikkonen. We saw that great move at Monza when he slipped down the inside of him. That's the kind of thing that we need in Formula One. We need the characters, and we need somebody with a lot of commitment on the race circuit.
Now, Kimi Raikkonen is a driver who needs nothing less than race victory today. What's going to be his approach to this Chinese Grand Prix?
Well, I think he's been very strong all weekend long, and I was actually quite surprised to see him not on pole position, because he was the fastest in every single session all weekend up until that final one in qualifying. He will be strong in the race, but I think Massa will have to play the important role again, trying to support him and taking away valuable points from the McLaren guys, and see whether Kimi can get into the front and take this victory.
And we're still getting those suggestions that there's rain about 7 or 8 minutes away. It's all very reminiscent of the final countdown to the Nürburgring, isn't it?
It is indeed. And it's a very big worry for the teams, and also the drivers sitting there, what they need to do next. I think they'll be watching their weather information. All the teams have got big amount of data, what's coming in the various forms. And they've got permanent weather people there sitting there analysing the different trends in the weather pattern. But
you know, it's one of those days again where these guys are really going to earn their money, Steve. Difficult conditions.
Charlie Whiting discussing precisely those conditions, the race director there with Ron Dennis. And do we share Martin's confidence that we won't be seeing the safety car today? Well, we'll see how much rain actually materialises in the next 5 or 6 minutes. Well, Lewis Hamilton's day, we applauded when he took a string of podium finishes. We were delighted when he got that breakthrough first win in Canada, but we never imagined that he could be sitting on pole position in Shanghai with a strong possibility of becoming the sport's youngest ever world champion. And I'm sure that thought never occurred to Felipe Massa or Fernando Alonso either. But that's the prospect when we return. The Chinese Grand Prix, a few minutes away.